Welcome back to another Logic Pro tip. And today I'm going to talk about the custom channel strips, which I was scared of for a long time. I would click on it and not know what it was doing, but it's pretty straightforward. It allows you to have a number of plugins turned on, either in a channel or in a bus or on your master, and then you can save that. So if you're wanting to use that again, like you make your favorite vocal strip or for your bass guitar or whatever instrument, you just call it up. So let's have a look here. I'm going to zoom in. You basically just click where it says setting, and there's a lot of different things you can do here. There's also a bunch that are stock inside Logic that could be useful, but I like making my own. It's really fun. I've got a bunch here that I've already saved. So let's make one, for example. So if we zoom out a bit, and I'm going to just throw on some plugins. So I'm going to put a FabFilter compressor and then a Pro-Q 4. Why not? And then is there a reverb? Yeah, let's put on a reverb. And so that's a channel strip. And let's save it. So we go to save channel strip setting as, and then you can see in my folder here, I've already got a whole bunch of them that I've saved. So we can name it Logic Pro Tip Example. And if I go and make a new track, I can then go to here and then pull it up. So there it is. It's amazing. So for example, if we wanted to do it on a bus, let's make a bus. And there's bus here, aux 1. Go to setting, and it puts it under kind of a folder thing here, user channel strip settings. But here's a bunch of buses that I made, drum buses and summing stack, that kind of thing. So drum bus, turn that on, brings up the plugins. On the stereo out for your master, same thing, user channel strip settings. Let's say mastering, you click that and it pulls up those plugins, and any changes that you've made within the plugins are retained too. So you don't have to really mess around. You may at one point want to rename something and organize it, because I tend to make a whole bunch of them. And then as I evolve, or my process evolves, I don't like what I did last year, so I got to get rid of it. So you can delete it. You can delete channel strip setting right in the program. But to rename it, I think, as far as I'm aware, you need to find it in the Finder. So it's in the music folder under audio music apps, and then under channel strip settings. So they give you all the different categories as separate folders. So the big one is track. So track has a whole bunch of these that I've saved. So if I wanted to rename it, let's fix the spelling on what I did there. So Logic Pro Tip Example, I'm just going to make that a capital T now, and it looks better. If you wanted to do the bus, there's my buses that I've made, and output is for on your master. So hopefully you can make use of that, maybe save you some time and make your production process more fun. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.